IVM.
Hello and welcome to the Habit Coach Podcast, the bite-sized podcast filled with quick and easy actionable habits. Remember, great habits create that awesome life. I am Ashdin Doctor, your Habit Coach. Today's fun fact of the day has to do with our sleep cycles. Did you know there are different stages and cycles of sleep? There are four stages of sleep. Stage 1, Stage 2, Stage 3, and REM, or Rapid Eye Movement. Stage 1 and 2 are called light sleep stages. Stages 3 and REM are deep sleep stages. You're more likely to wake up during a light sleep stage, but if you wake up during a deep sleep stage, you'll feel groggy and tired. These four stages form one sleep cycle. Like this, we go through multiple sleep cycles every night. One sleep cycle typically lasts for about 90 minutes. So the old belief of 8 hours of sleep per night is actually wrong, as you would wake up in the middle of a deep sleep cycle. Have you ever had a nice, long sleep of 9 or 10 hours, only to wake up feeling tired and groggy? What happened? The problem is, we've been brought up to think of sleep in quantitative terms. I sleep 5 hours, I sleep 8 hours, I sleep 12 hours. Quantity is just easy to measure. Hence, it became the default. But it is not the ideal way to measure your sleep. When we only think quantity, we only focus on increasing the time spent in bed. However, with today's busy lives, we don't have that extra hour to spend sleeping. So we need to improve our sleep efficiency. Significantly, we need different quantities of sleep at different ages. Notice how teens sleep for long periods of time. It's what their bodies need. As we age, we tend to sleep lesser and lesser. The quantity of sleep is also dependent on the season. In the winters, we tend to sleep longer durations than in the summers. So overall, quantity of sleep is not a reliable measure. I like to focus on sleep quality. Measure how much deep sleep versus light sleep we get every night. Measure how long each sleep cycle was. And measure when in the night did you get the most deep sleep. Today, measuring sleep is becoming easier and easier. Earlier, we had to be wired up with electrodes and made to sleep in a special room at a laboratory to measure our sleep data. Wearing the electrodes itself must cause some form of sleep disruption, let alone sleeping in a new environment. Nowadays, we have a host of sleep trackers. Here are a list of my top trackers, and this is not a sponsored podcast. These are trackers I have used. The MI band. I use this every day, and so do all my coaching clients. It has a good sleep prediction algorithm. It's simple to understand and easy to use. Divide sleep into deep sleep and light sleep. And it's the best value for money. Fitbit. This gives a little more data than the MI band. The algorithms are different, so you cannot compare the data. The Fitbit is also much more expensive than the MI band. Apps on your phone. I've used an app called Sleep as Android. It is fairly accurate, gives a lot of data, and remember to keep your phone in airplane mode if you sleep with it next to you. I strongly suggest investing in some form of sleep tracker. If technology is not your thing, then a simple notebook by your bedside to write down how long you've slept for and how you feel after waking up. Follow this and you will see trends emerging, giving you greater insights into your life and your sleep. My friends and I often compete on who's had more deep sleep using the data from our sleep trackers. Anything more than 40% deep sleep is brilliant. So your simple habit is to wake up and write down how you feel and how much you slept. Or check your sleep tracker for more information. Keep doing this for a month and you will be surprised by the results. Example, how just one glass of alcohol dramatically decreases sleep cycles. Take a screenshot and share your sleep data with me. Use the hashtag TheHabitCoach. So start these habits and share with us your progress using the hashtag TheHabitCoach. If you like this podcast, don't forget to check out other interesting podcasts on the IVM network. You can listen to us on the IVM Podcast app or ivmpodcast.com. You can also follow us on social media. We are at IVM Podcasts on Twitter and Instagram. If you want to reach out to me, I am Ashdin Doc on Twitter and Instagram.
Hello, everybody. We have a brand new daily podcast we're working on with Bloomberg Quint. All You Need to Know provides the top news on business, markets, and the economy so that you can stay ahead of the curve. Tune in every morning on BloombergQuint.com, the IVM podcast app, or wherever you get your podcast from.
Every week comes a show where three people come together to tell you about stuff they like. A movie, a TV show, a book, and other stuff. Tune in every Monday on the IVM podcast app to IVM Likes. Batman approves this message. Thank you, Batman.